Well, good afternoon, everybody. Figure I'll just make a video here of what I'm doing today again. Supposed to be nice for a few days. I'm trying to get the rest of my stockpiled manure hauled out before I start hauling some more over here with the truck. I did get the truck hooked up to the semi-trailer or the end dump trailer this morning. When I was around the yard there. And I'll probably just make a little video and then of like one load, and then I'll do some high speed probably for those people that for some reason like watching manure spreading videos. I guess it's same shit, a different day. I didn't haul manure for a few days there because it got really cold. Like the highs was like 10 degrees or so, and there's chunks. You can still see a chunk once in a while, but they've been breaking up for me really good. But that one day I tried to haul, I end up knocking a chain off because I had a frozen chunk in there that didn't want to break up. And I finally gave up on getting it out, and I had to go get an axe and stuff to make it smaller so I could lift it, because I couldn't lift it out. So, anyhow, that's kind of what's been going on here lately. Been working on manure. I built them drive over gates for my dad, and well, I mean, it's nice for everybody not to have to open gates to go check cows. I've done that when it was a little colder. Been back out hauling manure. I wasn't a teach a hired man how to haul manure, but he decided he didn't want to work here any longer, so he's gone. Had a feeling it was coming. He wasn't showing up only half the time, so. Anyhow, when someone does that, I guess they don't want a job too bad. Turn the radio down so I don't get in YouTube trouble. Won't be too much longer. We're gonna be drilling oats and stuff, so I need to get the drill hooked on, and this tractor is the one that I drill with because it's the only one that has auto steer. And I'm not a big fan of driving if I don't have to. But there's an old wagon, very nifty little thing. Too bad it wouldn't have been put inside. It'd actually probably be worth something if they could drive it in a parade or something. And when it was so cold, my rye kind of shut back down, so I don't know if it killed it or what, but I think it'll end up coming back, but there's some places it doesn't look very good, so I don't know what happened if it, I don't know what the deal is now, but we'll see, I guess we'll see what it is once we're done. I guess if I kill it by hauling manure on it, I guess the ground needed the manure. I don't really intend to leave this as rye to hay or to do anything. I just wanted to graze it, so I guess we need to haul the manure out somewhere, some way, somewhere. And I shifted up a gear. Now I'm going almost 7 mile an hour unloading this because I'm trying to get clear across the field now. And I'm getting pretty close to that. Actually, that end of the field here is where I had all that manure piled, but I ran out of that pile, so I had to relocate to the pile up here that was not in the field. And it just takes a little bit longer to haul, but it's actually not too terribly bad. There's one of our food plots for hunting last year. Got left We don't do anything with it. We just let the deer and stuff graze on it all winter. But I don't know. I had a couple people say they like manure spreading videos. So I guess that's why I'm making one. I guess I don't care. It's just don't want people to get mad because they're doing the same stuff. But I guess if they don't want to watch it, if it's the same thing that I done the day before or a week ago, I guess they don't have to watch. But like I said, we'll do one load normal speed, and then I might do a couple more or whatever on high speed and just see how that turns out. I'm not sure if you guys should put music on the high speed stuff or just listen to a bunch of bumblebees is what it sounds like when you're watching that stuff with the engines revved up and whatnot. But I'm gonna be gone here a couple days. My daughter's birthday, and we're meeting my wife's family out and about so we can see them, because they live quite a ways away, so we don't get to see them very often. So we're actually gonna go somewhere and go hang out with her family and the kids and stuff. I think that'll be a good time, so I'll be gone the weekend anyhow. And then when we get back, I think we'll be pretty close to being full swing farming. I'm thinking anyhow, because it's already gonna be mid-March and I need to get my drill hooked up and checked over and make sure everything's up to par. So I need to order stuff. I'm not ordering it the day I need it. I think for the most part I can drill some without doing anything, but I know I got some seed tubes that are needing some work and whatnot. Probably just put new ones on. And I just got, like I said, just got several things I want to make sure. Got some bushings that I think need, that I need to work on a little bit and get freed up. But I'm not sure what I'm going to do with when I'm going to start drilling, I guess, for sure. I don't know how much I'm going to drill, how many acres for sure, but it'd be nice to get started. I gotta do work on some maps and figure out my acres and stuff. My landlord hasn't decided for sure whether he wants me to do it on chairs or whatever, or just custom do it, I guess. But I need to start figuring out the maps so when he decides I can tell him I got a plan put together and stuff, and we'll see how that goes. In other words, we're just calving the cows, and I can't remember how many we've got, but we've got a pretty good chunk of them done already, which is nice. I probably won't actually ever say how many cows total are around the farm here. I guess that's not my information to share. How many cows my brother and my dad have. Like I said, I've got 50 cows, so that's how many I've got. Around 50, give or take a couple. Don't figure we need to be exact. And we'll kind of keep you guys up to date on my cabin, probably. And I've actually kept like 14 I'm gonna fatten in the calf lot there. And I'll probably make a video of in there one of these days. My dad kept some too that are in there. We'll probably kind of use them fats that I've got as how much it costs to finish an animal from a certain weight. So I've actually got most of their weaning weights. I've got their weaning weights and all their weights last time they were weighed and stuff, so I might go through that with everybody. And then kind of next time we implant them, which would be about probably 90 days from now, give or take a few days, I'm just guessing. We'll do a little bit of talking about that then, and the cost, what it's costing to feed them and what they are getting fed and stuff like that. So Another thing, I guess, that I'm gonna mention, I think we're gonna end up getting some bottle calves. I think we're gonna get some, my wife's gonna get some bottle calves and just see how that goes. I think that it's a lot of work. I know I watch some of you guys do bottle calves on your channels and stuff, and seems like a lot of work, but I guess she's seen you guys' videos, and she says, well, it must be doing somewhat okay, or you wouldn't be doing them, which I guess I tend to agree. I think it's a lot of work for what you might get, but we will see, I guess. We talked to the nutritionist about, you know, what to do, and got everything kind of lined up. Last night I worked kind of late working on getting the barn ready that we're going to use. We're going to probably do the calves down at our house to keep the animals away from our new calves in case they happen to have anything wrong or whatever with them. Diseases and whatnot, keep it away from the main farm. And see what happens. I guess I had someone recommend that if it's possible. So that's what I'll do until they get bigger and we know they're okay. So then we'll take them up to the main farm where they can be with the other calves when we wean. We'll probably try to keep them down at our place until we start weaning some of our cattle, which we'll wean some of them early because they're cows that we want to get rid of because they're mean or they're old or they have bad udders or whatnot. We'll keep them separate from the rest of the cows, and we'll wean them pretty early in the year as soon as we feel like they're old enough that they can do okay without their mothers. Then we'll sell their mothers and start feeding the calves. And stuff like that. But this is all the manure left that I've got stockpiled in the field, this little pile here, which seems like the pile just keeps getting, I'm not gaining much on it, I guess, but I haven't really, like I said, worked on it much the last few days. I've just been doing other things and it's been too cold, so. But anyhow, I guess I think I'll finish loading this one and we'll throw the rest of this on high speed for the people that want to watch and the people that don't want to watch. I guess thanks for watching. If you made it this far, I appreciate it. I appreciate all the comments that I get. Likes and dislikes, I guess. I don't really like the dislikes, but I guess thanks for being honest. Keep watching my channel and we'll keep putting up videos and hopefully they get more entertaining than just hauling manure. I guess to some people this might be interesting, but I need to get some videos done on some no-till stuff, and I'm gonna go out and dig in some fields, I think. Some of our cover crop fields that we had cattle on. Some of our, I'll just make another video. But I'll make another video of videos to come, I guess. So this will be the end of this one as far as me blabbering my mouth off. I'm gonna stop this one and start another one once I get in the tractor, and I'll get just a high speed of a couple loads probably. So thanks for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe for more. If there's anything special you guys want to see, if I can do it, I sure will. Thanks. Bye.